Welcome to the Small Member Squad podcast, episode 196. I'm one of your hosts, Egg Platinum. We also have Young Laugh. He's muted.
Yes, sir.
And we have T-Bone. He's also muted.
Hey, how's it going, guys? You know.
And we have Brad.
No, I didn't get done yet, man. Jesus. God, let me finish my thing. Fuck Brad. It's your boy.
I did not consent to that. Thank you very much.
Fuck you. Fuck you. You don't got to consent to shit. Five. Don't know why only five, bitch.
That's the start, but okay.
You know, Brad's bitch ass.
Mm-hmm. So, anyone been up to anything new fun over the last week?
No.
Not really.
Work, man. On that grind.
Been at home with the boy. The new boy.
Sounds fun. Better than my job. I mean, one kid, good. Once you add more, that's when it becomes a problem, Brad. Yeah. Get snipped. Just kidding.
Yeah, I'm waiting like 3 or 4 years before that happens.
Yeah. Good idea. Most doctors won't even do it right away.
No.
You gotta have like five kids. Yeah.
I think it's like minimum 3 or 4 or like 26 or 28 before they even consider it.
First of all, bitch, it's my body, my choice.
That's what I was saying.
Yeah, basically.
My body, my choice.
What it should be.
Mm-hmm. But, you know, not in America.
Nope.
Bullshit.
Mm-hmm. Real.
Yeah, no, nothing fun or exciting. Life's pretty boring. Yeah, that's about it, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know.
I didn't really do much.
You, man. Yeah, then grinding Xtify, and man, you have to be on that.
Nah. We've been watching 911, the one that's based out of L.A. And then
I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
It's a TV series.
It's a cop on ABC. Show.
Yeah. Oh. And then I've been grinding a little Ape Escape on a PS2 emulator.
Decent game. Ape Escape is a classic.
Yeah. I'm on Ape Escape 2 right now.
How many are there?
Like 3.
It's like 3 or 4, yeah.
Is it about
kind of stopped at
a game about
it's pretty go capture a bunch of monkeys. Because they
they're not just regular apes. They got some special helmets on.
Yeah, and they're basically mind controlled.
Mm-hmm. That's why they escape
stuff.
Tanner.
One game back in the day, I miss is that Rampage game, I believe it was called.
Yeah.
Yep.
You play as the giant ape, the electric eyeball. Or...
That was fun. There's a bunch of different characters you could have, and that yeah, the one I remember was Rampage Total Destruction.
I was gonna say there's a few different versions. There's the original arcade one as well.
This one I really remember, the one from I think it was the PS1, and then there's one on PS2 I remember a lot.
Well, yeah, man.
Yeah, the one for this PS2 probably would have been Total Destruction. That was to me kind of goated. You could do a lot of cool stuff.
I remember there's one on the Wii. I played that.
Yep.
There was also a three-dimensional one. Like an over-the-shoulder one.
That might not have been.
I don't think that was Rampage. There were Godzilla games like that.
What?
Yeah.
There were Godzilla games where you literally fought against other, like, the other person, and, like, you destroyed the city and shit.
I don't remember what the name of it was, because we didn't actually have the game disc of it. It was, like, a game that had, like, 14 demos on it. But it was fun. Just drop in. It was split screen, so you could fuck up your brothers.
Remember when games used to be like that? You just split screen?
Rip split screen and rip LAN.
Screen beacon.
So some friends of ours on the wife's side dropped by today, and we ended up playing zombies for a good hour and a half, 2 hours.
That's
Black
zombies.
Ops 2.
Okay.
Black Ops 2. Yeah. A good one. And apparently you can't do multiplayer zombies on there.
Damn.
Locally. Apparently that's a console-only exclusive.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, why would you think you could do that on PC, man?
I thought you could.
You got to think of what the games are designed for with a console.
Yeah, bro,
they're designed to have
tripping.
A controller for, you know, up to four.
Yeah,
or
four
in the case of PlayStation,
yeah.
up to seven controllers. Where in
there's
PC,
no reason to have
just
that
keyboard
on
and mouse.
PC. Yeah.
So, you know, it's only one user.
I mean, we were doing it on controllers, so.
I mean, you can connect controllers, but that's not what the PC is
for. Yeah, but that's not like, sure. Yeah, that's not the main intention, though.
If you want to go and play out with a controller, go and play on your Xbox.
Mm-hmm.
Well, see, it'd be fun, but we don't have an Xbox.
Well, sounds like
I know what you mean, though.
Fucking peasant.
Cheap, man.
Go and get yourself a nice gaming, modern gaming console.
It would be nice if I had the cash right now.
Yeah. Get a 360 for dirt cheap.
I mean, that's true. Like,
and the mod.
Then it'd just be going through and finding the games.
Well,
wait, that's what he was just saying. He's just
literally just solder some shit onto the board.
You just bridge a couple of points.
Yes.
And then and you got
solder.
A fully customizable 360 with customizable dashboard and everything, man.
Yeah, I missed the 360 dashboard. If you were to turn on an Xbox 360 right now, have it all updated and everything. Dashboard is great. I love it.
Of the early iterations.
Comparing it to the Xbox One dashboard.
That's whatever.
I now see what Oil was
like
talking about.
The early 360 ones was so much better than the later ones.
Where they had like the arches. You know what I'm seeing? Where it's sort of wider on the top and bottom.
I like those ones.
Indeed, man.
But the thing is that when it's modded, you can set it up for whatever you want. Fully customizable, baby.
That would be pretty cool.
A lot of options on that thing. It's pretty cool. Just haven't looking into it, man.
That was just boring.
It's pretty epic. Gotta get do a little research before the con, you know. We need to get that cranking, bro. Actually, speaking on that, I've been reading some shit too. You guys are looking for a nice manga to read. I don't know if it's gonna get adapted at any point, but fucking Sakamoto Days, very good. Excellent recommendation.
Okay.
It was picked up by Netflix originally, but I don't think anything ever happened with it. Like, I think it got dropped or some shit. I wouldn't have watched it on there anyway, so fuck them.
Who the fuck has Netflix?
Fuck Netflix.
Mm-hmm. I mean, most of it gets uploaded anyway, so it don't matter to me. I got my fucking ways of watching it type shit.
Mm-hmm.
I don't gotta fucking pay for it. The same way that I read my shit too. I don't fucking pay for a physical fucking book, bro. You know how expensive that shit would be?
Very.
Indeed. Well, a lot of it's not translated either, but ignore that fact. But
yeah, it's not really important.
Well, it is actually.
Nah, I just learned how to read the language.
No, there's trash translations out there. What the fuck? I'd much rather take the French translation, bro. Like, I would rather have the official for sure, but don't get me wrong. The French translation's more than fine enough type shit. They know what they're doing. They're experts. And I let them work. Yeah, man, that shit's good. Y'all should check it out. It's probably my favorite show right now. That or, Vinland Saga. I've been reading that too, but it's just been out for a couple of years, so.
So what was that look, Brad?
What, Vinland Saga?
Yeah, he mentioned Vinland Saga and you gave a nasty look.
I don't know. It sounded interesting. Caught me off guard.
It's just World War II type shit. Pretty cool.
So you'd be like, Korean War stuff.
More like Tyann, or whatever that fucking one with the bitch where, like, she's, like, the dictator or whatever. I don't remember what that fucking anime is called, but he gets, like, reincarnated as a dictator. It's pretty good, too. A lot of war anime is pretty decent.
Yeah,
that shit's looking pretty good.
Probably some of it isn't animated.
A lot of it is.
Oh.
Yeah, it's like the shit that doesn't get animated a lot of the time is like horror shit for whatever reason. Like horror shit usually never gets animated. And then like, I don't know, they love fucking their slice of lives. Oh, there's always slice of lives, and then there's always fucking isekais, so. And I kind of don't like either. Well, I don't mind a slice of life every now and then, bro. That shit's kind of good.
Yeah.
Like, fucking, Chifuyu. Fucking, Toradora.
That one I've heard about. Usually good things.
It's fucking one more. OJ gave me the DVD of it. I don't remember the name, but I remember the plot. It's about, like, these group of friends. and one of their friends died with their kids or whatever. And then, like, it switches between, like, you know, the past and future and shit. Like, it, like, I just remember, like, him having to reunite the group or whatever. It was a weird one. Very weird anime about, like, a dead chick.
What the hell?
Mm-hmm. But not the weirdest I've ever watched. Like, with that same premise. That's the fucking, I always forget the name of this. It's not gonna matter anyway. Yeah. No one's gonna watch this shit.
No.
But it's a fucking anime about... Well, I was talking about the anime, man. The episode we watched, bro. What the fuck are you talking about, Brad?
No, we're not watching.
Oh, well, hang on. I want to hear what you... Oh, bro, what are you talking about? I'm talking about the anime. It's not great. You know, it's kind of mid, if I'm being honest with you. It's about a dude wanting to fuck a zombie.
Oh, well, everybody's been there.
I don't see it. Yeah, I was going to say, I don't see any problems here.
Well, there is no problems. He makes a zombie. Like, he has a zombie girlfriend, but it's not the issue. And it's like, but I don't, it doesn't matter. Also, there's a cat in that one. He wants to, or his cousin wants to fuck him too in that one. That's like a major plot point too about that.
Oh, obviously, you gotta have the little competition going for the girl. Gosh.
You could say that. But that's also just a common thing. In fucking, like, Japanese culture. For whatever reason. I mean, it's probably fucking similar in other cultures, too. But it's whack. Yeah. That shit's whack. Fuck. Yeah, Tanner?
I don't know, man. I don't judge. I don't judge.
I judge when it comes to that.
Yeah, no, sorry, I wasn't listening, but yes, I don't judge most of the time.
What?
I wasn't listening. Sorry. Amen. I'm in my own brain right now. It's a rough day at work.
Talk about That's it, fair. Man.
Yeah, so it rained all day today. And, of course, my job entails me being outside. And, you know, I don't have any rain pants. I just have a rain jacket. And it all drips off the jacket onto my pants. So my pants were just soaked the whole day.
Just waterboarding your phone in your pocket the whole time.
Yeah, my phone and my fucking headphones in my pocket the whole day. They're fine. But those pants got heavy and, you know, at least it was a slow day. Our whole entire park, we only had like 89 people. Which average day is like 3,000. So we closed early, but of course I didn't get to leave right when we closed because I still had shit to do.
Yeah, you gotta make sure everything's closed plastic. Down.
Yep, tomorrow I'm going in for day number 7 in a row. It sucks.
You like that, brother, but man.
Finished this week with 66 hours.
God damn.
That's a lot of overtime.
But tomorrow is technically like double time because I got paid 8 hours for Memorial Day. And then it's paid for regular time. So,
is it supposed to rain tomorrow all day?
I saw it was supposed to rain in the afternoon, but who fucking knows, man? I don't.
What does this say? Who knows?
These damn fucking meteorologists need to get better at their jobs.
Dude, for real, they haven't gotten any better in the last like 20 years.
But no, it's supposed to be cold for the next couple of days, and then it's supposed to warm up to the 70s at least.
Ah, lovely.
But. We had a motor blow up at work.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, at least I wasn't the one. I wasn't the one starting it up. It didn't explode, I guess, but it started fucking, you know, sparking really bad and shit like that. So, and it was the one I hate turning on and off because it's loud as shit, so I'm happy it died. Fuck that one. Yeah, man, just getting to the full swing of the season. Better than preseason. Preseason fucking sucks. I hate it.
Real.
And I guess OJ hasn't. He's going on his 8th day in a row, I think, tomorrow.
Yeah, he's
a man's on the grind. He didn't. He worked from on what was it? Friday. He worked from 6 a.m. until 10:30 p.m.
Fuck that.
I left that day at 7:30. Said fuck this. He's like, I want the hours.
I was gonna say that's the only upside. I said you get the hours, that get paid for it.
And it's all overtime money too.
Mm-hmm.
Should be even better.
Mm-hmm.
It's worth it.
So
yeah, won't catch me doing something like that.
Well, because you're salaried, bro.
Mm-hmm. It's 5 o'clock. I'm like, all right. Time to go.
Well, that's the time we left during the preseason. It's 5 o'clock, but we'd get in at 6 in the morning, 7 or 9. Or 8. I don't know what you do.
Yeah, I come in at, I go 8 to 5.
Hour lunch would be nice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm 8 to 4.
It's funny. My coworker actually negotiated in his contract that he only gets half an hour lunches, but he gets to leave a half hour early. I'm like, damn, I would have taken
that. I'd like that. Yeah, I would have liked that. Just seeing like, all right, bye
as,
guys.
As it sits right now, I'll sit there and I'll just gobble up my food real quick, like, you know, 10, 15 minutes.
And mac and cheese, because that only takes 30 seconds in the microwave.
3 minutes and 30 seconds, all right.
Okay, my bad. Takes you a minute to scarf it down, so you got, you know, another 55 minutes to kill.
Mm-hmm. So that's why I have my laptop back there. Usually have it at work.
well, I got this 55 minutes. I might as well grind on something.
Might as well grind on Halo. Actually, it was Dark Souls for a while. Completed that. Now I'm back Elden Ring. Well,
the first one. He literally said it. You not listen? Come on.
No, bro. I would have said Dark Souls 2 or 3.
Yeah, okay.
I'm sorry.
We're half in this conversation. We're tired. I see it in Brad's eyes. He's tired.
Mm-hmm.
I sleep when I can, aka when the boy sleeps.
Yeah, Tanner knows. You gotta do it. I know the pain. Yeah. I see it in your face. And you see the life slowly draining. Trust me, I look way different before I had the kid and then now.
You're so full of life.
We started this podcast before.
No, I think it was. It was right before.
Yeah, it was just before it.
It was literally right before, man.
But it wasn't a video. It wasn't video.
Okay,
I think he's right. I don't think Tanner was on the video episodes until after his kid.
Photos of me before and now. I'm like, whoa, completely different dude.
Nah.
I'm like, so I know the struggle, Brad. I see you're tired.
It's okay, Brad.
Let me say, it doesn't get better.
Thanks.
This is I needed life.
That. And it starts to get better, and then you have another couple of them come.
No, it doesn't.
No.
It stays bad so far. I mean, maybe they start sleeping through the night, so that's good. But then once they start learning how to talk, and they don't listen to you, so they only know how to talk and not listen, that's always fun. And then you add more to the mix, too, so you're starting all over again. Having twins, honestly, it's not as bad as it sounds. Compared to just one. But, yeah, man. Tiring. Yeah, Austin's going to have some kids soon. See it.
Oh, yeah, totally.
First time he's going to accidentally bust and knock a chick up.
Get a triplets right off the bat.
Oh, my God.
I would laugh in your face. I think you'd kill yourself.
That, I don't know what I'd do.
Kill yourself.
I think he'd do okay. He's pretty good with time management and stuff.
Or just say, hey, I gotta go get some milk and cigarettes.
Yeah, I agree with Tanner, bro. I don't know, man.
Especially off the first, like, fucking first nut with a chick. And you knock her up, like...
Yeah, maybe, that's crazy,
maybe
bro.
At that point, you'd cut your balls off, too, first. Just to make sure, why did I do this to myself?
Yeah, make sure this never's happening again.
You'd have to sell your computer because you need the space. You only go for a laptop only, and you have to sit on your couch, and then you only get 20 minutes a day.
Laptop only, it's crazy. Yeah.
You only have 20 minutes a day to game, and that whole time you hear kids screaming the whole time.
Nah, see, that's what the Steam Deck is for.
And then they smash your Steam Deck.
Real.
Even though you put it in a place they'll never get it, they get it. And next thing you know, it's fucking just they accidentally put it in the sink or the toilet.
Probably actually the worst thing they could do. Because just about anything else I could probably fix.
They put it in the fucking toilet.
What do you mean, bro? You got rice? Stick it in there, bro.
Nah, bro. He's got enough mac and cheese packets, like the fucking little things he's pouring those.
Dude, every single thing of plastic comes with a packet of silica gel.
They're fucking just dumping the cheese packets onto the fucking.
Shit, I gotta make the mac and cheese for lunch.
Might as well use this water one.
Yeah, bro. Got a good full use out of it, bro. Come on. Can't waste any of it.
Surprisingly, I haven't got one of those, tea where it warms the water in it.
Right away. An electric kettle?
Kettles? Yeah, like a kettle that have it on your desk the whole time so you don't have to waste the time to microwave it.
It would take too much time to fill up the water on that thing at work.
Well, you fill it up early, like when you get to work, right? Just doing your thing, get water in it, and then, have it automated where you eat your lunch at fucking noon. You have it start heating up at 10 o'clock, So by the time it's new.
Whoa, what the fuck? Bro, these things. I don't think you realize how fast the electric kettles
No,
work.
I don't.
It heats up in literally like 15 minutes.
Okay, no, not even that, dude. It's like 15 seconds. I could plug one in right there and have it boiling. Right.
Well, see, that's what you'll do, man. You just get that going, and then lunchtime, and just stir, and then boom, you're done.
Real.
And then you'll be like, "Damn, I saved 3 minutes and 30 seconds on this." Even though you'll spend an extra, 5 minutes going to walk to get the water and setting it down, and having a program to set it up. You know, whole time thing, but I'm surprised they haven't done that yet.
No, it's pretty easy to just put water in the cup and then stick it in the microwave.
Yeah, but it doesn't seem like you, bro. You always come up with you probably have some. You'll get something 3D printed.
Something 3D printed. I don't know what the fuck you're yapping about right now, but like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Wild stuff, that's for sure.
Like, you're talking about, like, Austin living in a fully automated, like, smart house. Like, yes. He's yes, there, it's man. 6 a.m. His fucking curtains start fucking rising.
He's gonna get
actually, fucking... I've been getting less and less of the smart tech.
Wow, that's surprising.
Yeah, it's just, it's not as functional as what is previously.
You know what Austin does in his free time now? He just reads user agreements. Like, all right, I got this agreement for fucking my toaster. I got to read it all.
I mean, it's pretty easy to just, control F and search for certain key terms.
Well, you see, you're proficient at it now. You've done it enough. Control F.
And it's also pretty simple when they put it in bold right at the top of the fucking terms. Fuck Blizzard.
It seems like once a week, Austin just sends
you have
a video
no right to say that.
Bitching about this user agreement.
You've never truly been through Blizzard's hell. And
well,
I'm willing
stole
to fucking buy that.
A few $100 from me.
Uh-huh. And they've stolen a few $100 from a lot of players from fucking
And
not
only that they steal
no,
they have a right to say
from
fuck
World
Blizzard.
Of Warcraft their account. Imagine you fucking pay for a fucking these mounts that only can be fucking bought through this fucking store. Your account gets fucking flagged for whatever reason. Your fucking name that you've had for fucking 20 years, the fucking for whatever reason your account gets fucking banned. Oh man, you can't play that shit anymore. Bye-bye to all the fucking skins you had, your weapons, and all that shit. You gotta put in a ticket and hope that they fucking read that shit. And a lot of people didn't get their shit, man. So for you to fucking sit here and complain for your fucking, like, $120 or whatever, man, you don't get this right.
I definitely do. Just because they lost more money than me does not mean that I cannot complain.
You can complain if you're a bitch, like you are, but you just still don't have that right.
Nah, I'm going to sit here and complain. Nah, and I'm not going to buy anything from Blizzard anymore.
I complain all the time about even stuff I don't lose money on.
Actually,
minor inconvenience, I'm mad.
I just ranted for 24 minutes and then uploaded the video to my old channel about all the... I'm just so fed up with corporations nowadays.
Next thing you know, Austin's fucking full anarchist.
I'm about there.
Turns into a fucking terrorist.
All right, I was just meaning like.
That's where you're going, bro.
Bro.
What are you talking about?
Next thing you know, he starts hacking. Instead of gaming, he's just learning how to hack into these corporations and take them down from inside. Next thing you know, Austin has a job at Blizzard, and he's just working his way up through the chain to fucking
shut them
down.
You need a job. You didn't do that.
Now you just get a job at Microsoft.
Or just say somebody there touched you. That's how you guys, Bill Gates touched me, and then make a big news about it. But then you probably get whacked.
I was going to say.
But is it the... The message, you gotta get the message out. Risk your life. And I'll say it on this podcast. Bill Gates did not touch me. I'll say that now. Yet. He hasn't touched me yet. Well, I mean, I've eaten the apples that has come off the farmland he owns that is filled with pesticides and shit that, you know.
And microchipped.
And microchipped, yeah. And all that shebang.
You got nanobots inside of you now.
Jesus. Hopefully they make me have more energy, bro. That'd be cool. I mean, if they did something cool, like, all right, fuck it. Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah.
It's like the Upgrade, or was it the Upgrade movie?
Yeah, Upgrade.
Sign me up.
He was paralyzed and had a computer chip implanted to be a bridge between his spine and his brain. Actually, exactly the same thing that Elon Musk is doing with the Neuralink.
sign me up, you know? Fuck it. Or if I could just turn my actual brain off for a little bit and just rely on autopilot.
You know, the stuff that I'm doing is pretty routine anyway. Just fucking, you know, figuring they can handle it.
Set on autopilot.
I'm all right.
You just get into the sunken where you see everything that's going on, but you can just chill in there. I'd be good with that.
Your consciousness and take a nap while your body just works.
Mm-hmm. Once, you know, like if you're at work, you clock out, you fucking back to consciousness. Oh, and you're God. Like, shit, I don't want to actually drive home. So you have to fucking go back out, let the AI drive you home. Well, you probably get a Tesla, fucking have that thing whip you home. Once you're actually home, you're like, well, shit, I don't actually want to sit in the shower. Boom.
Sounds like Tanner just doesn't want to do anything in life.
At this current moment, energy-wise, you know, a little stuff autopilot. You know, if I'd have to drive to work and home every day. Justin!
Bro, it's not even that much of a fucking inconvenience, man.
No, it's really not.
Like, the shit you're describing is, like, so minuscule that it wouldn't even be fucking worth it to get this shit done. Like, the amount of time you would save, what the fuck are you gonna do with it then?
Rest?
Well, you were resting while you were fucking working. So you just said, yes, I will now
sleep. You just don't have to sleep. You just don't have to sleep.
That would be cool. If I didn't have to sleep, like if I just had the same
amount of energy. No, it wouldn't.
Yeah, fuck yeah, it would. If I didn't have to sleep.
Oh, dude. I think you're underestimating this, my man.
Oh, man. I would love not
to sleep. There's a foolproof way to not sleep anyway, right now. You can do this at any point.
But then you die.
Well, if you do too much. Oh, people have done heroin for a long time, Tanner.
Oh, God. I don't think it's meth.
Oh, well, same thing.
I think heroin's the downer.
Same thing. Sleep more. You nod off on both, so.
Yeah, you do nod off. Yeah.
Same shit.
How about we just start all hitting fentanyl fucking cards, bro?
I've definitely done it.
Just fucking bent over the whole time.
Mm-hmm. Nothing beats a little fenny, bro.
Yeah, moved to Portland, Oregon.
I got you.
With the culture.
Oh, bro, I got you right
here. You got to surround yourself by the people you want to be around, and that's all in Portland, Oregon.
Well, you mean you can go to San Fran for the same thing.
San Fran. Any, you know, liberal big city, actually.
For the most part, on the West Coast, yeah.
Yeah, West Coast. Well, there's not really any in the East Coast.
Well, no, because they're not retards.
Yeah. Yeah, fuck the liberals.
Are you fucking kidding me? Like, yeah, I don't side with it either, bro. I don't give a fuck. That definitely ain't the solution. No.
But it might be if natural selection starts taking point, you know.
Natural selection's always going to be the fucking, you know, an option, man. That's always there.
Yeah.
I'm saying we should take the warning stickers off of everything. Like, if someone's dumb enough to see an industrial grinder, see it spinning up and go, yeah, I'm just going to stick my hand in there, they don't deserve to have a hand anymore.
Yeah, but then that raises stuff with insurance on their part and liability.
Yeah, that there's a lot of questions then.
Yeah.
They made the decision to stick their hand in there. That's on them.
Fair,
man.
Yeah, I mean, that's an extreme example.
Yeah. I kind of agree.
Second it.
Yeah.
Third it.
I was going to say that'd be three.
Yeah.
Brad can't math.
Listen, okay? I can barely keep my days straight.
Are they a little
gay? I mean,
gay?
I could be that. I mean, that's just normal.
Is a little gay there, Brad?
I mean, having six weeks off feels like it's a piercing into the future of retirement for me.
Dude, retirement. Hopefully it's fun.
If I ever get to it, too, yeah.
But then I gotta have a hobby. That's gonna be the hard part, is having hobbies.
I feel like my hobby's gonna be
golfing. I might just go fishing, golfing. Maybe hitting the Fed cart, you know.
I agree, man.
Or just do a bunch of mushrooms the whole time.
You can do that now.
Sleeping in all the time. Getting 8 hours of sleep.
I have no idea what to do. Probably golf each morning.
That's why old retired people die shortly after. People you see live in old age just because they keep working or fucking keeping themselves occupied. Get into some bird watching. Yeah, yep, that's a bird right there. That's a government spy right there. Look at that
robin over there.
Government spy.
Mm-hmm. You see all the different models they have?
Yeah, this one's a fucking blue jay. Fucking, you know what that one is. You know, NSA.
I probably should get an RV and travel.
I wouldn't get an RV, bro.
RV, maybe just camper.
I would just, yeah, a camper or fucking just fucking tent, bro. I like
a van even,
bro. Yeah,
I mean, like at that age in the 60s or 70s, I'd probably just do a camper, say screw it.
Yeah, you have a camper because
then you know you
camper you can RV, whatever,
set it up at a camping spot.
How big of a camper are you going? Getting like a little teardrop camper? You getting one of the full length bitches?
I mean, if it'd be like just the two of us, I'd say probably like a 20 to 30 foot.
Damn.
Hey, if it's the two of us, let's get this massive thing.
Bro, if I'm doing all that, I want, you know, a simple trailer. Small.
Mm-hmm. I was talking about the RV.
RV.
And it'd probably be a toy hauler, so I just keep the golf cart in the back.
Yeah,
it's just so much work to get it anyway.
That is a lot of. I wouldn't do all that. That's way too much shit, bro.
My buddy Heath and Anastasia have a little teardrop one. It's like the same length as a full size truck. You know, just enough for you to sleep in.
Yeah, we used to have a pull behind camper, and then we got RVs.
A little pop up one.
That's what my dad has.
Yes, we had that one too, a wild long time ago.
My father-in-law has 5 campers.
Jesus.
Yeah.
So we just borrow the tent.
He keeps getting them for free.
How? What?
I don't know, man. He's like, I'm getting a new camper. But this one I can't take anywhere. It's a fifth wheel. I have nothing to fucking pull it with. Like, well, you go up to his place and he's got like, you know, his house is down on the hill, and then up on the hill, he's got a shop, and then he has like 4 campers right now, and he's getting a 5th one.
Oh my God.
So he has like a whole community basically up there of just his campers.
I wish I had that kind of problem.
Yeah. Right. He just keeps getting them for free. I don't get it. Or he got a boat for free too. The motor wasn't working, so the guy said, fuck it.
It's fine. You got a little paddles, you know.
He didn't look into what was wrong with the motor at all.
You could fix it up, bro. But yeah, what the hell are you talking about? Like,
yeah, it's got a big motor on it that it stopped working. He didn't look into any reason why it stopped working or anything like that.
No, that's crazy.
And he's like, "Yeah, fuck it," and bought a new boat. And he's like, "Well, you want this one?"
Fuck.
And he's like, "Yeah, yeah, I do want that one."
My God.
You know, I was wondering how there managed to be like a brand new boat store, you know, boat / pontoon store that was put up. But if there's people doing shit like that, I mean, I guess it makes sense.
Yeah, people have enough disposable income where and they like doing a hobby on boats. They say, fuck it, I want a boat.
There's one for us that's a family friend. They fucking do real estate, so they get all sorts of boo-boo money. At some point in the summertime, they went out and got a freaking like Wagoneer or Grand Wagoneer or something. Then they,
I hate
because they had to figure out what to tow with their boat that they just bought. Like, what?
And you fucking put the cart before the fucking horse.
Yeah, that was on straight cash too.
Yeah, get our fucking new boat. Ah, shit. How the fuck are we gonna fucking haul this thing? Can't even take it off the lot. We got two sedans.
Bro, you can just have someone in the trunk fucking holding on to it.
Now they just fucking weld it into the trunk, a fucking little ball, so they fucking hook it on top.
Oh my God.
Like, yeah, that'll work. The ratchet
strap. You guys don't have that on your car?
No, I got trailer hookups on my cars.
No, I do not.
I got a four-way and a,
dude, a six-pole. Before you get rid of your fucking car, we gotta hook up a trailer to it.
Oh my God!
There's no hookups.
What do you mean? Can make one. You can attach it. There's ones you attach to the frame of the car.
Yeah, I was gonna say we can get it done.
Yeah, there's.
It wouldn't be able to do anything, bro.
Yes, it could. It could hold a 2 foot long trailer.
It could hold pull a board. maybe even a 2x6 board.
Watch the MPG go from like 36 down to like 18.
36, bro.
The fucking transmission slipping like a motherfucker.
Watch it finally go.
You just,
dude. That's why I'm saving up money right now. I'm just waiting for it to fucking die.
Oh, it's okay. The motor's revving high, but the transmission's got to catch up to it. It's got to warm up. Got to get the fluids fucking going, all right?
Oh, my God. I'm a focus. Look at me go.
Or we got to cut the roof off of it. That'd be bitching.
That's a permanent convertible. Oh, boy.
Oh, hell yeah.
You're
right. You know, might as well cut as much off of it as you can. You got to say weight savings.
Yeah, to lose weight, bro, yeah.
Yeah, weight savings. You know, I want that 40 mpg to be 45, baby. Yeah, you lose aerodynamics, but the weight's a big factor. You get the smallest rims and tires you can, and you're like, hey, unsprung weight, that takes a lot of MPG.
Dude, it's pretty close already.
Nah, you can do better.
I think it has, like...
Move the back
seats. Actually, no, I think it has, like... I think it, like 15 is, like, a standard, right? I think it has, like, 14 or 15.
Still feels tiny.
Yeah. You could fucking put golf cart tires on it.
Oh, yeah.
I got my new golf cart at work. It's fucking bitching. Fully electric. Into the future.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, baby. It just has like 6 batteries inside of it.
You got Spotify integration?
I wish. I should. I am going to trick it out. I'm going to get a mirror for up top where I can see behind me. He has one. I'm jealous. I'm getting Tesla logos put on it.
Understandable.
I got a name for it already. I got to get that on a sticker on it. Her name's Carmen. Carmen Electra. And let's see. I want to get a speaker attached to it. And I need to get a horn because I sneak up on people.
And it's electric. And it makes no noise now.
It makes no noise. The only noise it makes is tire noise, which is quiet. I can talk on the phone on it, unlike the other golf carts where it's loud as shit. But it's quiet. and I sneak up on people constantly, and I just have to yell at them to get out of my way.
Get out the way.
I'm like, ah, excuse me.
Using them as speed bumps.
I got to look out how to take the governor off of it. The only thing I don't like about it, well, a couple things actually, it has regenerative braking. And it's really random when it wants to, you know, turn on.
So a lot of times that's a settings, I think, right?
I don't know. Because, like, I'll be going down the hill and then it'll kick on really hard. But then it'll just stop. Or if I'm going down that same hill a different time, it won't do it at all.
Yeah.
And I'm relying on it to do it because I'm like, oh, I think I learned this.
Do the generative brakes count as engine braking?
Technically.
I feel like it would.
Yeah, technically, because it's your motors that are slowing it get down, regenerating, causing.
Yeah.
Maintenance-wise, I got to put water in the batteries.
You have to put water in the batteries?
Yeah, bro. What? You don't know that? Yeah. What the fuck is it called? Electrolyte. The water has to get electrolyte-wise. So, like, they have a hookup for it, already hooked up. I got to get, like, a ball fucking pump thing to have it up to put distilled water in it at fully charge.
That makes no sense because distilled water isn't conductive at all.
You know, I ain't no scientist. I don't know how it works. It's got to do something with the fucking plates and the batteries. I don't know, because he's supposed to do it on a full charge, too, because if you don't, it...
Is it with like that? Is it like that with full-size electric as well?
It depends on the battery technology. I don't think it's a lithium ion.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, lithium ion, I don't think you do that, but for it's escaping me. The other type of fucking battery you do. Like your car battery has water in it.
Lead acid.
Yeah, lead acid. Your car battery has it unless you have like there's newer ones you can do. And God damn it. Made Dawson swear. But yeah, I gotta do that once a month. My cup holders in the cart have changed. I found that out the hard way.
Your drink doesn't fit anymore?
No, it fits. It fits. They used to be in my old cart. They were in the center, right underneath the canopy, always in shade. Now they're on the fucking edge of the cart. And yesterday I parked my cart out in the sun doing something. Come back, you know, half an hour later, go to take a drink out of my Yeti cup. It was fucking hotter than the motherfucker. Spat it right back out. I'm like, motherfucker. So that is a bad spot. The handle, the little grip handle on the top there, it's a little thicker than the old one. So I used to clip. We have a gate, like a remote gate. And I used to hook my remote up to the top there so I could just go up and click it. But now it doesn't fit.
That sucks.
So
sounds like you gotta get some like double-sided tape.
Yeah, I would, right? But people probably would steal it, and that's the one somebody's been stealing all the fucking clickers. So I had one for my cart last year and one in my car, because if I get to work early, the front gate's closed, so I just click it in my car. But somebody stole my one out of my cart, so now I only have the one, so I have to use it I have to fucking bring it with me.
That's fucked up.
Yeah.
Yep. Or if I get to work late or something like that and the gate's closed, you know, I could walk around to a different gate, but that takes me an extra, you know, 2 minutes. Bullshit. But I got to take it with me back and forth. But she rides smooth. I haven't had any problems with running out of battery.
Fuck you, man.
Makes everybody else jealous. Like, OJ is jealous of it because he had to take it for a minute. And he's like, damn, I didn't realize it rode this smooth.
So something I learned is that I didn't realize that you had to charge the electric portion of hybrid vehicles.
Mm-hmm. It depends on, I guess, each vehicle system is different too. It's like when I drove that Prius for a month or whatever it was, it was a hybrid, but it recharged like on
off the engine.
Yeah, off the engine, or if you're like regenerative braking wise.
Yeah, see, that's what I thought, because like I was looking at getting doing research on hybrids for down the road when my car mm-hmm. does die, and that's what I thought, is that you just drive the car normally and it uses the gas engine to recharge the battery. But my dad got a Ford hybrid vehicle, and he has to charge it separately.
Yeah, everything, all of them are different. Like Toyotas, I don't think they're plug-in hybrids are those. And then there's just hybrids that do regenerative braking and all that. Then there's different types of hybrids where the motor in it is only there to charge the batteries. So it's no drivetrain to the tires from the motor. It's literally just there to charge the batteries.
So a good example of that is the new Chrysler Pacificas.
Mm-hmm.
They have that hybrid model, which is actually more or less just electric. So that still has a 3.8 V6 that's been around for a decade now.
That's all over the place.
Yeah. So basically, you have the option to fill up the gas tank, and you have the option to recharge the batteries. So the batteries last for, I think, 50 or 100 miles, somewhere in that range. And then the engine usually kicks in. Temperatures also vary, too, so there's differences there. But when you look at the actual mechanics in the drivetrain, in all technicality, the motor is actually not even a part of the transmission. The motor is just there as a generator.
Mm-hmm.
So you got a V6 as a generator, and that's it.
Reminds me of a short that I saw of someone who pulled over to help a Tesla driver, and he's like, "Do you have any gas?" And they're like, "What? It's a Tesla. You can't use gas." And he pops the trunk, and he just has a portable generator.
Yep.
Like, man comes prepared.
There have like companies out in like big cities that will, if you run out of battery, they have a diesel generator they pull with their truck and will come recharge you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's funny sometimes watching it too. I've actually saw a Tesla. This is more towards the Chicago area, if I remember right, Chicago, Milwaukee area, where there was a Tesla that had an actual, like, it was like the Model X, like the bigger one. It had the trailer hitch, and there's a generator behind it. It was just charging it as it drove.
I saw where the charging stations. The charging stations, and then like right behind the charging stations,
right around the corner,
is a giant diesel generator that's what they use to charge everything. It's a giant diesel generator. Yeah, no, hybrids are cool. Toyotas I'd lean towards. Fuck Ford.
Yeah,
don't buy American for anything hybrid.
I've had enough problems with my Ford that I'm not going to get another one.
To somebody who's been doing it for 2 decades, like Toyota.
I think technically Toyota was one of the first, but if you want to go by technicality, Detroit Electric was the first one back in like the 1910s.
Well, that's not, I don't consider that.
It's not irrelevant at this point, but yeah. History-wise, yeah.
Yeah, and that car couldn't go faster than 30 miles per hour and only had a range of 30 miles.
No, it's...
You're thinking of the Model T, dog.
Yeah.
I thought that one was even slower.
No. I would think you still get up like 20 miles an hour or something like that.
It could get up there a bit, yeah, but...
But the Detroit Electric, that one... I think that was 30 miles an hour. Let me... Now you gotta make me look it up.
I was gonna say, that's what I said.
Yeah, they didn't go that fast because, tire technology, too, hasn't caught up at that time.
They were really skinny.
I mean, look at how much wider they are now.
And roads, too. Road, technology wasn't up to par.
I mean, as well as the width of the road. I mean, you can look at the downtown where we went to high school as a prime example. It was designed around thinner roads.
So it's 20 to drive through now. 25 miles an hour, range of about 80 miles Okay. If you got the Edison battery. Oh, actually, it was advertised reliably getting 80, but apparently you could do 211.3 miles.
Hmm. Yeah.
Well, impressive for being 100 years ago.
I don't know, man. Sounds like fake news.
I don't know. There's not many of them around.
I'd feel more comfortable with battery technology if it got better range and it was sourced more ethically and there was a better power structure to charge it all and stuff. You know, yeah you're saving the environment, but you know, to produce that electricity, you have to burn so much more coal.
Yeah.
Or, you know, if Tesla wasn't so shitty, I guess.
Well, another thing that's turning me away from it right now is that there's not really a place that I would be able to plug it in to charge it. Electric, that is.
Yeah, not really in this area.
Like, you know, if you have a house and a garage, that's fine. You can just plug it into a regular 110 outlet.
If you do it on 110, though, it takes like 2 days.
But it's fine. You could get home, you plug it in, you let it charge overnight, and you get a little bit more miles. You
could do 220 though, but if like most houses are hooked up for 220.
But I live in an apartment, and there's only one charging station for the parking spot. For the entire building of people. And there's at least one other person that has an electric vehicle that parks there almost every single fucking night.
At least now they're all coming up to a standard too for charging.
Mm-hmm.
Compared to what it used to be, yeah.
The Wild West and everyone gets adapters to work with other
stations. There is chargers not too far from you at the hospital. There's like two of them or three of them.
Oh.
There are now?
Yeah, there's fast chargers.
Oh, okay.
That's cool.
More of an option now, but I'm still probably not going to go full electric. I like having the option of gas.
There's some up in the town Zach lives in, not too far from him, too.
Yeah, I think were there for a while. I think those were the first ones in our area.
Yeah, that area, there's a couple of them. There's, I believe, at that gas station.
Or up where Ozzy was. I think that actually was the first one in the area.
There's a couple of them. But, you know, once everybody else is more adopting it too, more spots will be taken up.
Yeah.
I'm surprised that more gas stations haven't added stations for them.
Because they're not going to make
Why would they?
That's additional power and additional money that they'll have to.
I mean, they just charge for it.
Well, maybe the new gas station they're building on the other side, closer to that Walmart, might have it, but I don't know.
I doubt it, man.
Yeah, it doesn't really make sense for them to put up their competitions.
Yeah, there's no reason for them to.
Unless they, you know, look too like very far in the future and they're like, gas is going to be going away, so we want to build up like a electric charging station where the technology will get fast enough where you can charge your car in 5-10 minutes.
Yeah, but that's like so far down the line, man.
Maybe
they make so much money off the gas now.
Gas stations themselves don't really make too much off the gas. They make like 9/10 of a cent off of each gallon.
Uh-huh.
And they make most of their money from in store.
Yeah, that's the real money that's in store.
So that's where they make the most of their money. I mean, they still go through a fuck ton of gallons of gas each day.
That's what brings the people in.
Yeah, you know, like, gas station. Yeah, we got our marked up stuff inside. You know, come in and look at this marked up stuff.
Look at this stuff that's really convenient for you while you're here.
Look at this gas.
In the future, I like driving my gas cart, my electric cart. You know, electric car would be cool, but I also
It makes more sense in this the smaller things, you know, leaf blower, yeah, weed whacker, that kind of stuff.
Yeah, yeah. Lawnmower.
But yeah, I don't see a dump truck going electric anytime soon.
Yeah, man, I ain't a vehicle visionary, so maybe, you know, technology will catch up.
I mean, eventually, but they have to find something better for storing electricity before they can do anything like that.
Yeah, there is like carbon nanotubes or something like that that is better than lithium ion, and it doesn't come from, you know, slaves in Africa.
I haven't heard about carbon nanotubes for electricity storage, but I have heard about other things like,
yeah, carbon something batteries, where it's a much more efficient, dense, so it could be an even smaller package, mm-hmm, and have more energy to it, and it takes less time to charge, but it's so expensive to manufacture. Well,
that's the problem that they have right now, is that lithium as an element is very volatile, so it's very easy for it to move the electrons from one to the other. So that's it's going to be very, very hard to find something that would function better in theory.
Yeah, I guess let me look up something.
Let alone remain stable too.
Well, I mean, that's the problem they have with lithium, is that if you use it to transfer the electrodes from the positive, or, you know, anode side to the negative cathode side.
Oh, sorry. It's graphene batteries.
Graphene. Okay. That I have heard about, but they've been working on that for a few decades.
Yeah. They're working on it for a while, which promises faster charging, longer lifespans, and greater safety than lithium ion batteries.
It's because of the temp. I mean, I don't know for sure, but I would assume that it's because of the temperature of it.
Austin, your car thing's dying in 2024?
Yeah.
They're bricking them all.
I was actually, that's something that was in my my little rant video. Fucking pissed off because this thing right here doesn't function through the Spotify API, or it may just function through Spotify API, but it connects through my phone. There's no reason. It just functions as a Bluetooth controller. That's all it does. There's no reason.
I could have told you that, but... Ripped to the money you spent.
Yeah, that whole $50 going to nothing. All I'm going to do is I'm just going to jailbreak it. There's a community working towards jailbreaking it for the last, you know, year or two.
Well, I'd do.
But I'm waiting for them to actually brick it before I do anything to it.
Smart. Be the better way to do that.
Mm-hmm. But it's so fucking stupid because I don't see their reasoning for it. Like, if they were offering a Spotify car thing too and charging, you know, $75 for that, I would understand why they're trying to brick these systems, but they're not doing that. They're completely they discontinued it back in 2020. They did a promotional sale for it to get rid of the remaining inventory in 2022. That's when I got it. And now they're saying that they're completely bricking it. It's going to be useless after 2024.
I remember when they claimed they're going to actually give it away for free.
There was a promotional period for like a, I think it was like a month after they launched.
Yeah, it was a beta
program. I really like it, and it you know, in my car, not as functional as what it would be for other people. But I still really like, my main use for it was just adding songs and removing songs from my liked playlist. That was my main use for it. But being able to access the playlist just on a shortcut on the top, that's really useful for someone that has like a 2003 Honda Civic that doesn't have any kind of steering wheel media controls or anything like that. I feel like this, having a device like this that's functional, is much more safe than having your phone right there for you to open up and unlock and then press the skip button. But hey, fuck me and all the other consumers that purchased this device, am I right?
I just looked it up, and it's solid state batteries. So instead of using liquid for the cathode and the whatever the other one is, it's all solid state. So it's smaller, more efficient, can hold more charge, and has 7 times longer lifespan than a lithium ion.
I think if I didn't, there was something they were. I think it was like the heat on those was the problem.
Yeah, the heat wise, because it's too compact to dissipate the heat.
Mm-hmm.
Produces,
and we already face a problem with that with lithium batteries.
Yeah, but at least with the solid state, they won't cause a fire.
Oh, I mean, depending on how hot they get.
I mean, if something else around them, yeah, it'll probably burn. But the battery itself,
yeah. Because right now, what happens with like a lot of the battery fires is that the I don't think it's actually the lithium. It's like
the electrolyte solution inside of it
reacts with the metal and oxygen and fire. But yeah, I just don't see any kind of new battery technology coming out anytime within the next 50 years.
Watch tomorrow, a fucking news thing's posted saying they just discovered a new battery technology that'll save so much money and energy and be more efficient and all this.
They found a new subatomic particle.
They can actually use the God particle to store energy.
Oh yeah, the God hand.
Mm-hmm. That's gonna be Austin's luck, and then you have to sign a fucking user agreement that says you don't actually own your car.
For you.
And Austin's gonna get pissed.
Yeah, I'll get pissed. You know, ultimately the goal is to just get a house right next to where I fucking work, so I can ride a bike.
Nah, bro, that's too close. You gotta have some sort of distance, like, you know, maybe a mile.
Like, there are some, you know, the turn off to go to where Tanner and I live from where I work?
Sure.
You know the apartments that are back there?
Yes.
Like, that would be, that like, that distance would be perfect. Like, maybe like, actually, no, it's probably, that's probably more like 5 miles.
Yeah, that's still not too bad. Except in the winter.
Yeah.
But hey, riding that's bike what you have to... balls off.
That's what Uber is for.
Taxi. Yeah. I don't know how big Uber is in that town.
Just taxi. And you don't have to pay for the car. You don't have to pay for maintenance on the car. You don't have to pay for gas. You don't have to pay for insurance.
I like having a car.
You don't like having a car?
No, I do.
No, that's not what
I do. I was like,
freedom-wise, you know, I don't have to sit there and wait for an Uber to come pick me up and charge me $6 to drive to the store real quick, and then another $6 to drive home, maybe, or. You know, or maybe like, oh shit, I gotta go hang out with my buddy. Fuck it. Yeah, let's go take my car. Fuck yeah. I don't know. We're going to work every day too, unless you live close enough where you could walk or bike. I guess that makes sense. Yeah, no, I just like having a car.
Yeah.
I can just hop in it and go. I don't have to wait on anybody else.
You guys ever find it funny how we were always raised to never get in a stranger's car?
Now we always get in strangers' cars. Yep. I actually haven't Ubered too many times. I think I've done it like once, actually.
I've never.
Or I guess twice on the same day. But that was I can do the Ubers. I'd much prefer if I'm in a bigger city. And if I don't know where the fuck I'm going. Yeah,
for the Uber.
You're like, oh yeah, well, I'll just call an Uber, pay the $15 to get to this place. I don't know where the fuck I'm going. And I don't have to park. Like we're going to a concert or something. I don't have to find a space to park and still walk. I'll Uber and have them drop me off.
Yes, sir. It's the best.
Oh,
yeah.
Or if you're fucked up.
Beat.
Always Uber. Never drive.
Always drive. Nah,
always never drive. Uber. Never buckle up.
Yeah. If you're going to crash, you might as well die like a man.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's true.
You know, never always heard about speed. People dying in car crashes before.
If you see a cop, if you see a cop on the side of the road, just turn off your lights.
Throw your beer can at him. I love the videos of fucking when they change the law where you can't drink in your car. And just think all these hillbillies are fucking like, what the fuck am I supposed to do? I just got off a 12-hour shift. Am I not allowed to have beers on my fucking ride home? What the fuck is this shit? What do you mean I can't pound a beer while my fucking kid's riding right next to me in the middle of my fucking 2-door truck?
Thought this was America.
Pounding her beers and smoking cigarettes. I thought this was American freedom.
You thought.
You could still, you know, having a beer on the road is fine as long as you're not over the limit, you know? In my opinion, if you're not over the limit, you're still okay to drive. Having a beer, that's not a problem.
Real.
No, don't take my advice. I'm not a smart person.
I don't know, dude. You're sounding like an expert. You're
spitting some facts out here.
The best beer is the best, like when you're on the road. That's like the best. You know, you're just sipping, cruising.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I always thought it was in the shower.
Shower beers are fucking great. Shower
beers are okay.
I love a good shower beer. That's the where it tastes the best. Like after you get done with work, you're all sweaty and gross. You fucking crack a beer in the kitchen, start getting naked, hop in the shower and just pounding it. It really takes, you know, makes the day worth it.
It honestly does.
Yeah, just, well, yeah, I want to crack open a cold one, take a nice hot shower with a cold beer, get the yin and the yang, even keel, you know.
Drinking yin yang?
No.
Yingling?
Coors Banquet.
Yingling's fire.
I've had it once when I was in Pennsylvania. It wasn't bad.
It's all right.
From.
Yeah, I was out there in fucking Lancaster. And I was like, oh, I guess I've, you know, never really thought about this beer before. Let me give it a shot because that's what they're advertising. Not bad. You know, I'm not really a beer guy anyways. Captain Coke's.
Yeah. I'm with you there.
I like a good beer, though. You know, after all, you got to work for the
beer. You just said you're not a beer guy.
Let me rephrase.
And then you fucking said Coors Banquet is your go-to. You are the biggest fucking liar I've ever heard. We're ending this discussion now. Nope. Wrapping up the podcast here. Nope. Shut up. Cry about it. If you're
not working, liquor is. You got to earn the beer.
Nah.
Yeah, you got to earn it. You can have a
fucking beer on the fucking course at fucking 6 a.m. You don't have to earn shit.
You're earning it on the course with your game.
Oh, you don't have to fucking earn shit. You're rewarding yourself with the fucking nice, cold, refreshing beer, man. I'm not fucking looking at it as the fucking, like, I have to fucking work for it, bro. I'm going to fucking crack up in that fucking summer shandy, whether or not the
summer shandy, okay, that's different. Those things are fucking fire.
I'll crack it open any fucking nice beer, frosty. Man.
Oh, yeah.
Oof.
I don't give a fuck, bro.
I'll
drink that Blue Moon. Piss.
Blue Moon.
Blue Moon's mid.
I like Blue Moon. It's good.
I like it too.
It's up there with Summer Shandy to me.
Coronas are up there too, but that's still pretty. It's
I like a good Corona.
I'd say Modelo's are better. Fuck Coronas.
Yeah, I never had Modelo's.
You missed out, brother.
Yeah, well, yeah, when I go to drink with my boss, he buys Coronas. So that's why I drink Coronas. Or if I'm getting them for free, that's why I drink Coronas. If I'm buying beer, Coors Banquet, Summer Shandy, Blue Moon, Spotted Cow. Maybe a Keystone if I want something cheap on a budget.
Disgusting.
Yeah, it is. But I'll pound those.
You could get hams for about the same price as Keystone.
Yeah, they're about the same to me.
for taste. Are they as flavorful, though?
Yes. Yes, Habs are.
Trust me. What's the alcohol volume, though, you know? I thought Habs were like 3-something percent.
What? I don't fucking know.
I don't think most people really know that. They just care about getting drunk.
I don't care.
They just care about getting drunk. Brad spitting
facts out of here. That's the fucking thing.
Hams are 4.7. All right.
I'm putting the truth out there.
Nah, he's fucking spitting facts, bro.
Keystone's 5.9.
I mean, if you're going off that, you can just start drinking.
That's Keystone Ice. And then Keystone Light is 4.13. So, Hams is a little bit more.
Yeah, plus it's just better tasting. Like,
I haven't had Hams in a while since I was like 21.
The last time that I had Hams was at Ian's place.
I haven't had Hams in a while.
RIP, that fire got him.
I think it's been about 7 years since I've had a Hams.
Hell yeah, man.
It's been a really long time.
All right, let's end this podcast. I want to go to bed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Check out the links down below. We got a full playlist as well. Check out
Austin's video about him ranting about user agreements or whatever the fuck he was bitching about Spotify.
Yeah, it was Spotify, Blizzard, Apple, Samsung, all of them. I'm just fed up with tech, just large corporations in general. So I voiced my opinion. But come back next week to see where we'll voice our opinion at 7. See ya.